on the ice here with 1:21 left. Now, you wonder about Gil Stein is if he's going to rule on the Ty Domi Bob Probert thing.
The
what
fans
would he
are
think
calling
about
for
this?
It. The fans want something here. They're responding as DeBrusk and Ogic are lined up against each other. You see DeBrusk backing off near the blue line there.
And
now
here they go.
Here they go. DeBrusk and Ogic, two number 29s. Drop the glove. Here they go. Tied away. Gil Stein wants to take fighting out of the National Hockey League, but the fans here would have something to say about that.
And now here we go. Kelly Buchberger and Sergio Mimeso had dropped their gloves, but Ogic and DeBrusk are still trying to go at it.
Boy, do the fans love this. That's as loud as they've been all night.
And is anybody hurt from this?
And Buchberger wants to go at the bench with Didick.
I think it's Sergio Mimeso. And there goes Gino Ogic off the ice. Maybe they should get a football rule where they call taunting.
No celebration after a touchdown?
Yes.
And you don't see coaches do that very often. After a player has a fight, he looks at Gino, Pat Quinn does, and says, attaboy, Gino.
Role players who know their role. That's what coaches and general managers want. There's a coach and general manager. That's why Gino's on this team.
You talk about three stars tonight. I know Gino Ogic has done a great job for the Canucks, scoring goals, harassing the Oilers, both, in the penalty box, getting under the skin of the Edmonton Oilers. Gino's done a good job, and here's another look at the two number 29s. They didn't even look at the drop of the puck.
The puck has to be dropped, or they get fined. That's considered coming off the bench unless the puck is in play. So you saw them wait till the puck hit the ice, and then they go at it. And this could be a